Hello, I'm Dr. Lulu Clark. Welcome to my channel, Hungry for History. As a historian, I'm always hungry for knowledge about the past and for understanding how the past shaped the present. I also love to eat and thoroughly enjoy cooking. I'm fascinated by the power of food that can break down walls and division and bring people together. In the first episode of Hungry for History, I'm going to talk about the origins of ice cream. Stay tuned. Who don't love ice cream, right? It is a perfect treat for any season. Modern ice cream is often made from cream, milk, sweeteners, and flavorings, with or without eggs. But the earliest form of ice cream had little resemblance to the ice cream we eat today. The history of ice cream begins with non-dairy chilled drinks. The ancient Greeks and Romans used ice and snow to cool drinks. It is said that the Roman Emperor Nero enjoyed icy refreshment flavored with wine or honey. Snow was sold in the market of Athens from the 15th century BCE. In the centuries before electric refrigerators, manual laborers were needed for harvesting ice from rivers and mountains. In the medieval times, Arabs drank an icy refreshment called Sorbets. The Persians and the Turks also had similar icy drinks that were flavored with fruits like cherries, pomegranates, or quince. Food journalist Laura B. Weiss, in her book Ice Cream, A Global History, notes that European travelers brought back recipes of ice drinks from the Middle East. They soon became very popular among the European aristocracy. Some historians credit Italy as the birthplace of modern ice cream. In the 17th century, Italians transformed ice drinks into a frozen dessert called sorbetto, as we more commonly know it, sorbet. It was made from sugar and ice, with fruit flavorings such as strawberries and lemons. Historians don't know who first invented sorbetto, but evidence showed that Antonio Latini, chief steward for the Spanish prime minister in Naples, was probably the first person who wrote down recipes for making sorbetto in Italian. In 1694, Latini published his book Lo Scalco alla Moderna, or The Modern Steward. In the book, he suggested flavoring ices with a variety of possible flavors like lemon, strawberry, and chocolate, and even more exotic ones like pine cone and aubergine. Latini also had a sorbet recipe made of cooked milk, which indicated a big step towards modern ice cream. His recipe: cook a pot of milk, sugar, and water, garnish with sugar, citron, and pumpkin, and then freeze. Many culinary historians believe that this milk sorbet is the first ice cream in history. In the late 17th century and early 18th century Europe, confectioners were more concerned about freezing techniques than ice cream flavorings. They were unsure about how much ice and salt they needed, how to insulate freezing pail to keep ice last longer, or how long it took to freeze creams. In 1718, Mrs. Mary Eales published the first ice cream recipe in English in her cookbook, Mrs. Mary Eales Receipts.
She wrote, "Take tin ice pots, fill them with any sort of cream you like, either plain or sweetened, or fruit in it. Shut your pots very close. To 6 pots, you must allow 18 or 20 pounds of ice, breaking the ice very small. There will be some great pieces, which lay at the bottom and top. You must have a pail and lay some straw at the bottom, then lay in your ice and put in amongst it a pound of bay salt. Set in your pot of cream and lay ice and salt between every pot, that they may not touch. But the ice must lie around them on every side. Lay a good deal of ice on the top. Cover the pail with straw. Set in a cellar where no sound of light comes. It will be frozen in 4 hours, but it may stand longer."
Although the Italian created what is now known as modern ice cream, the French set the style of ice cream for 18th century frozen desserts. French confectioners adopted the Italian way of making ice and frozen refreshments and created their own style. In 1768, a Frenchman, Monsieur Emy, wrote the first book entirely devoted to ice cream. He had ice cream recipes with very interesting flavors, like artichoke, avocado, anise, asparagus, grated cheese, and amber. By the mid of the 18th century, as confectioners had worked out the freezing techniques, they became more audacious in trying out new flavorings. Flours, nuts, spices, and bread all were among the ingredients used to flavor creams. Amy also suggested flavoring ice creams with rye bread, macaroons, biscuits, or cookies. He crumbled them into a basic ice cream mixture as it cooked and then passed the mixture through a sieve before freezing. Amy also molded ices and ice creams into decorative shapes. Most ice cream molds were made of pewter, and those in the shapes of other foods, such as fruits, vegetables, and fish, were very popular. French confectioners created a frozen dessert called fromage, not because they were made of cheese, but because of the type of mold they were frozen in. According to culinary historian Jerry Quinzel, in the 18th century, fromage glacé or ice cheese was a type of ice cream frozen in round, fluted, or wedge-shaped molds to resemble different sorts of cheese. Emy had a recipe to make fromage de ananas, which was simply a pineapple ice cream frozen in a cheese-shaped mold. In Victorian times, asparagus-shaped ice cream was very popular among the British upper class families. Plain or vanilla ice cream was generally used to form the asparagus stalks, while pistachio or greengage plum ice cream formed the tips. Another contribution made by the French to the history of ice cream was the creation of new drinking and dining institution, cafe shop. In 1686, a Sicilian, Francesco Procopio Cuto, opened the first cafe shop in Paris, Café Procope. It served sorbet and other refreshments, and soon became the gathering place for many famous intellectuals like Napoleon, Voltaire, Victor Hugo, and Benjamin Franklin. Cafe shops like Procope serve as important community gathering place, paved the way for ice cream parlors and soda fountains that came later. Some French consider ice cream had magic health benefits. In 1775, a Neapolitan named Filippo Bolodini produced the Sorbets, the first book entirely devoted to the art of making frozen desserts. As a physician, Bolodini touted the health benefits of ice desserts. He recommended cinnamon for relieving aches and pains, lemon ice cream for easing ailing stomachs, and chocolate to improve one's mood. The 18th century saw ice cream become all the rage among European aristocrats. But only the rich was able to afford frozen desserts. Ice cream was expensive partly because ice was hard to get. Today, as refrigerator is a must-have household item, it is difficult for many to imagine ice as a luxury product. Wealthy Europeans built ice pits usually near to the main house to store ice collected from ponds and mountains. Early ice houses were pits sunk in the ground and covered with heat insulation materials like straw or sawdust. English King James I had two brick-lined snow pits dug at Greenwich between 1619 to 1622. During the rule of his grandson, Charles II, who spent much of his exile in France, ordered ice houses to be built in St. James Park in 1660. His royal court followed suit and had ice houses constructed at their London mansions and country estates. In addition to ice, ingredients to make ice cream were very costly. Flavoring spices and nuts like vanilla, pistachio, rose water, and almond drove up the cost of ice cream. Vanilla may sound humdrum today, but in the 18th century, vanilla beans and chocolate brought from Mexico and Central America by Spanish conquistadors were considered exotic and were not cheap at all. Ice cream, to some extent, helped to introduce ingredients like vanilla, chocolate from the Americas to European cuisines. In the next episode, we are going to talk about how ice cream crossed the Atlantic Ocean and made its debut in the United States. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please hit the like button. If you like to see more videos, hit the subscription button. What do you find interesting about the origins of ice cream? Write down your thoughts in the comment below. I would love to hear from you. This is all I have for you today. I will see you in the next video. Bye!